to check it, can you?
Yeah.
Shows YouTube it is. On Facebook too?
Yep.
Oh, that was so weird. Okay.
I think if you... I have to swipe it to see comments.
I tried and it was just like... There we go. Okay, there we go. Got it. Okay. What you want to do, just let me know.
So what?
You lead the way. Have the nervous shits. He's been there for a good 3 to 5 minutes already. Hesitation, you know? Hey guys. Okay. Hey. Yeah, like what's he gonna do?
Huh?
I said, yeah, like what's he gonna do? If he's still swimming, we need to go.
Huh?
He's walking that way. We need to go.
So who are you here to meet, man?
Some person that I met.
Some person you met?
Yeah.
And how old was that person?
I guess we'll find out.
We'll find out. You want to have a conversation? I'm not the police. I'm not the police.
I'm not here to hurt you.
I'm not here to fight you or anything weird like that.
I mean, I know what you're probably thinking that it is, but...
Okay, well, listen, do you want to go talk over there? If we stand out here, someone will call the cops. I'm sure you don't want the cops to come.
No.
Right, so
can we... I'm not here to do anything that's...
So you don't care if the cops come?
I mean, I do, but...
Okay, well...
I'm cold,
listen,
to be honest.
Listen, you can leave if you want. Like I said, we're not the police, bro. But I would like to have a conversation with you. So let's just...
Can we at least sit inside?
Yeah, we can do that.
I'd be warm. I'd be fine with that.
I didn't come looking for trouble or anything like that.
Well, it's... We're just talking. Okay? Is that cool?
That's cool.
You are free to leave whenever you want. Like I said again, we're not the police. We don't want trouble either, but we do have to talk, man.
I don't mind talking to you.
Okay? We appreciate it.
but I mean, like I said, I'm just looking to meet a person.
You can talk about it, bro. I hear you out, man. Maybe this is misunderstandable. Jesus. And yeah, we are filming just for our protection. Because we don't know you.
That's cool.
Right. But yeah, so Emma.
Thanks.
Do you mind taking your mask down so I can have an actual conversation with you? Well, Demetrius, we already have your picture, so like, you know, be like, you know, so it doesn't matter.
Yeah.
I mean, you don't have to, but I prefer you to have a man-to-man conversation.
I appreciate that. Thank you.
I appreciate it. So, how old are you, bro?
24.
24. And the person that you came here to meet is?
I've had different ages, so.
You've had different? No, how old was the person that you're here to meet?
She told me different ages.
What, like
during
what?
The video chat, everything from 19 to 14. So I was just gonna see. That's why we're here at the Burger King, meet in public.
So during a phone chat or video chat, she told you 19?
19, but she's also said 14, 15, 17.
She said all those ages?
So I don't.
She said all those ages?
Yeah.
Well, what if I would tell you that we have the video chat?
Do you?
Maybe.
I could be wrong, but that's how I remember.
I'm going to know when you're lying. So I just want the honest truth, bro.
I honestly think she might have, at the beginning, said 15, maybe.
15?
Maybe.
I mean, you're getting closer.
14?
You're almost there.
13.
You know how old she said, bro, right?
I know. Look, it looks terrible.
Right. And I'm not, dude, listen, I'm not here to judge you. I'm not here to be like, oh, you're a fucking piece of shit, disgusting motherfucker. Like, what we do is, we do this. Like, we find guys talking to underage.
Right.
So, let me explain what had happened.
I just don't want you guys to think that I was actually going to go back to her house with her. We're here at the Burger King for this purpose.
Okay. Okay, well, I'm not saying that. That's what I'm trying to figure out. That's why I wanted to talk to you. So what had happened was, this girl was supposed to meet you here.
Mm-hmm.
So she went home. Her mom called you. And she called us.
Okay.
Because we know her and she knows that we do this. So she was like, I got this guy trying to meet my daughter.
Right.
So that's what we're doing. Okay. So I've read through most of the messages. So,
right.
So, I mean, what are you doing, man? What's going on?
Honestly, do you have
a problem?
I can sit here and I can look you right in the eyes and I can tell you, this is as far as it was gonna go. Quite honestly, I know the text messages they say, all that stuff, but this is as far as it was gonna go.
So you were saying one thing in the text messages. But you're going to do something different.
I want to meet here at the Burger King so that there's no, I guess the word would be like impropriety, I guess you would call it. So that the wrong idea doesn't come off, even though it probably already has.
Right. Well, yeah, when you look through the messages,
they look really bad.
Right, because I mean, did you say anything inappropriate to her?
I honestly did.
Like what?
I honestly did.
I read through some of the messages, but if you could just fill me in on everything that you said that was inappropriate, just so I know.
I do remember her asking me what I wanted to do, and I said things like, we'll go to the park, go to the movies. Right. I asked, whatever you want to do.
Right. Well, anything inappropriate?
Sex. Might have talked about that.
You asked her if she wanted to have sex with you.
I don't think I necessarily asked, but we've had conversations about whether I would want to or not. But
okay.
I decided before coming here, before I made this whole trip and everything, that at least the last few conversations anyway, that's why, I don't know. It's hard.
Well, since you decided before you came here that you weren't going to do anything sexual, obviously. Did you tell her that? Was that in text messages that you changed your mind? Yeah, you can look it up if you want. You're good.
I believe it was, actually.
So what are you looking for right now?
Right now I'm looking for the last few text messages that we had. Because we had a conversation about what I would want to do when I got here, and I said, go to Burger King and then go to the park.
Okay.
Yeah, but doesn't specifically say you didn't want to do anything that you already said you wanted to do.
And just so you know, I'm not saying that this is what you're doing, but if you're deleting stuff, that wouldn't be a good idea. Just say that. It wouldn't matter. Like, let's just say you're deleting it because you don't want the cops to see it or something.
Yeah.
If I called the cops and they took your phone, it wouldn't matter if you deleted it, right?
Yeah, I know.
They dump it, and then you could probably get another charge for deleting evidence. Right. I'm just letting you know. I'm not saying that's what you're doing.
Right.
But I'm trying to avoid the cops coming here. Right. So that's why I prefer honesty.
Well, I'm telling you, man to man, I'm looking you right in the eye. This was not going to go any further than the Burger King. That's it. I was not going to go back to her house.
So you were just going to come here, eat with her?
Going to come here, maybe take a walk, whatever.
So it was going to go further?
Further as in sexual. Just.
So why did you talk about sex if you weren't going to do it?
You know, honestly, I couldn't tell you that. I don't.
Yeah, because you came a long ways, you know, just to eat and go for a walk.
Yeah. Well, I only came about an hour, so it really wasn't that far. It cost me like $15.
Oh, it's $15.
$15.
What was it? Was it a Greyhound?
Yeah.
A Greyhound?
Those are that cheap.
I didn't know they were that cheap either. That's what it was. That sounds like in the house.
Honestly, I think, I don't even remember where I met. Maybe, what was it, Facebook?
Some dating app. Mm-hmm. I don't remember.
But no, I got here last year and we haven't really been able to, like, branch out and meet anybody. So I'm just.
Me kinda, as in you and your girlfriend?
Yeah.
So your girlfriend, does she know you're here?
Yeah, she knew I was coming.
She knows that you're meeting this person.
Mm-hmm.
She knows that she's 13.
She knew that she was somewhere.
Yeah, I'm not your girlfriend. You can be real with me, bro.
No, honestly, she knew she was in that age bracket.
What age bracket?
In that bracket of, like, the middle teens.
So she knew she was underage?
Right.
She was okay with it?
She was going to come with me to meet her, so it would be more safe, I guess. But she ended up having to work.
Okay.
You said that you were coming to meet her and you were gonna bring your girlfriend.
Mm-hmm.
What would you have done if your girlfriend was here? I'm confused.
She said she wanted to make sure that I was safe because she didn't know if it was gonna be like a catfish or any type of thing like that.
Right. Well, because in the conversation, from what I remember, you talked about having threesomes with.
Yes.
You're going to have a threesome with the girl that you came here to meet.
Right.
And your girlfriend. So you.
Was your girlfriend aware of those conversations?
Right. Yes.
She knew about it, everything?
Yes.
So she was. Your girlfriend was okay with having sex with a 13-year-old?
She was okay, but I don't know. It was kind of her idea for me to take this meeting and see if this was real or anything because.
It was her idea.
Didn't really believe that she was who she said she was.
So it was your girlfriend's idea for you to come here, not yours?
To take this meeting, because I had changed my mind.
So your girlfriend sent you out here to meet a minor all by yourself.
She had to work today.
Come yeah, on, but she man. Sent you out here. That's crazy.
Damn. Really? Like,
she didn't send me, but she said, if you want to go, then go.
But you said you changed your mind.
Yes, I changed my mind.
But then you said she sent you. You said first you said you changed your mind, and then she said go, or she sent you, and so you came here.
If you read the text messages, I said that meeting new people kind of gave me anxiety.
Okay.
Right. You can relax. You can relax.
Yeah, you're good. We're not angry. I'm just trying to understand you. That's all. I'm just trying to understand you.
And if you go back through my history, I don't have any sort of...
Your history? Your criminal history?
My relationship history or sexual history or any of that.
Uh-huh.
All of my people, they are overage. I don't have any sort of... I have kids myself, so...
Oh, you do?
I have a daughter myself.
With your girlfriend?
My daughter is two. So, I know that I wouldn't want somebody... I wouldn't want her to get into that sort of situation.
Right.
So, and I actually, yeah, let me show you.
Is that your girlfriend's baby as well?
No.
Okay.
What are you showing me now?
I'm going to show you a picture of my daughter. Okay. This is my baby. Looks just like this. She's not talking.
Don't get on the camera.
No, I don't. No, she's pretty.
Yeah, man. So, like, when she turns 13, you probably wouldn't want a grown man
right.
saying, you want to fuck, you want to have threesome.
And to be honest, even just a grown man coming out just to meet her, give her food, and walk with her. Because, you know, how would you feel if even just a man wanted to do that with her?
Right.
You have to know that there's ulterior motives.
I'd be
that.
Suspicious.
Yes.
Honestly.
Suspicious?
I'd be losing my shit.
If it was my daughter, bro.
I'd be losing my shit.
I mean,
I would.
I mean, honestly, like, if it was your daughter, what would you be doing right now? Like, say...
Probably beating somebody up.
Exactly. Okay, so why are you here right now? Like, are you just... That's why I'm thinking that you might have a problem.
I mean, I do have some here.
What do you mean?
A lot of them.
Well, what do you mean? Are you meaning, like, a disability? Or are you meaning, like, your thoughts?
More like have some messed up stuff that kind of happened to me earlier on that kind of messed up my ability to like connect with people and make friends and stuff
you
like
when
that.
When you were a younger kid?
Yeah. I was about 5, so.
Oh, wow. I'm sorry for that. It shouldn't have happened to you,
really,
whatever it was. But you are an adult now. You
yeah.
know what I'm saying?
So, I mean, I had a day off of work, so I just like, why not? I don't really have anything else to do.
Yeah, but you do realize that you're saying that I just had a day off of work. I wasn't busy, so I decided to go meet a 13-year-old girl. You know
yeah,
what I'm saying?
I know.
It sounds so much worse.
So, like, we're here to try to help you, dude, but we can't fucking help you if you're not going to be honest. Like, did you honestly change your mind and the Burger King was as far as it was going to go?
I did. Like, honestly, I can look you right here.
Then why didn't you tell her that?
And the man.
Right. But you understand why it's hard to believe. When I'm reading a message that's saying, let's have threesomes, do you want to fuck? It's hard. You don't understand why that's hard for me to believe, right?
I understand.
Right. Okay, you know that you can get in trouble for that, right?
Yeah.
Even if you didn't show up here, you could get in trouble for that, right? Even if you think if you told a cop, oh, I changed my mind, that, right? Like, they're still gonna arrest you if the cops showed up or something. Like, you knew that risk, though, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, and you still showed up, man. So that's why I'm like, this man. I'm assuming you have a problem. Is this the first time you've ever talked to a minor?
It is. This is the very first time.
Okay.
It's never happened before.
So what's different now? What made you, just the opportunity showed up, maybe? Like,
was there something about her?
I don't know, I guess maybe
So much. Like, you can be honest. Even if it sounds like we wouldn't want to hear it, I'd rather you be honest. You know what I'm saying?
I think maybe the fact that I've struggled so much since I got here to find somebody that was actually willing to come and hang out with me.
I thought you said you had a girlfriend, though.
Yes, but she works quite a lot, so I don't have anybody else. My kids don't stay with me currently, so it's just me and the cats.
Yeah.
When I'm not at work, it's just tea.
Yeah.
And I struggle to make friends with...
With just anyone, is that what you mean? People?
With people in my own age group.
Right.
Especially not having a car and everything like that.
Yeah. And I do understand that, but again, I just don't understand why a 13-year-old girl is your best option. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, I grew it up and I take responsibility.
Sucks. I know life's hard sometimes, but I don't see any excuse for someone, an adult meeting a child. There's just... You can't give me an excuse great enough for that.
There is none.
Yeah.
There is none. I screwed up. That's on me.
No, at least you're admitting it, and I appreciate that, because that actually means a lot to admit when you've messed up and you've done something wrong.
I fucked up,
language. No, talk however you want.
And I really shouldn't have been here.
I agree. But yeah, I appreciate you being honest. That does go a long way.
And about it. Really nothing else I can say about that. It's just... I fucked up.
Yeah. I agree. It's kind of a shitty situation, but... I mean, I'm going to be honest, though. At least we were here. You know what I'm saying? Because I know you keep saying that your intent changed, but... Reading those text messages, there was only one intent that I got out of those messages. There was just one.
I understand how that can look at me. But also, knowing the risk, I can honestly say there is no way I would have gone through with it knowing all that can happen.
Sorry, wait. You wouldn't have gone through it knowing what could happen.
Everything, like this, for instance.
You're saying if you knew this was going to happen, you wouldn't have done it.
Anything could have happened. So there was no way that I would have taken a risk, as in, okay, let's say I did go back to that person's house. Who knows what could have been there?
But Demetrius, you're here. You did take that risk. You know what I'm saying? You did. You took a huge risk. You're here. You're sitting right here in front of me. You did. I get what I think what you're saying is you regret what you did, but it kind of sounds shitty, if I'm being honest, that you regret that you got caught instead of you regret the decision you made because it was wrong and it should have never happened.
I regret the very first conversation, all the way back to the very first time that we talked.
To where she told you her actual age. Yeah.
Like, I should have cut it there.
Yeah, I agree. You absolutely. The second she dropped her age, you should have just blocked her. That would have been the absolute best thing.
So why didn't you?
I think I didn't really have anybody else to talk to, so I was just kind of happy to have somebody that I could text.
Right. Well, I mean, I get that, but the problem is...
But like, it shouldn't have been that way.
Right.
Yeah, she's 13, and you turned it sexual. Like, if you don't have anyone to talk to, okay, I can understand that. But then you turn it... So why are you turning it sexual? That's the main question.
I don't know. Maybe somewhere in my brain I felt like... Maybe this person wouldn't want to meet me unless there was, like... an option or an opportunity or something like that. I don't know.
Did you try?
Try to...
Did you say, hey, let's meet up and do this, do that? And did she say, no, I don't want to do any of that?
I did. They're in your messages somewhere.
And she said, no, I don't want to do any of those things that you're offering.
somewhere in those messages, I think I remember her asking me something about, was I sure that I didn't want to fuck or something like that. They're in there somewhere.
Right. She, yeah, I saw that part. She asked you because she was wondering, because that's what you said. So she was just asking.
Yeah.
Because you said.
You brought it up, then, yeah.
She was asking what you said. And she wasn't saying, hey, you want to fuck?
Right.
But even then, dude, like, you're still an adult. Like, there's really not an excuse.
Yeah,
like,
that's what I'm saying.
Like, it really doesn't matter.
Dude, even if she was like, let's fuck, it's still wrong.
Yeah.
Like, there's still no excuse as the adult, you know what I'm saying?
I should have cut it right in the middle. And I didn't. And that, so, I have to take responsibility right. for that.
So you're still, you're still saying that you don't have a problem with, like, thinking about underage kids, minors?
I don't. This is,
you've never thought about a minor in this way, ever?
I've never had one before.
So you don't like look at CP or anything?
I'm asking if you thought about
it. Say that again.
You don't look at, like, porn?
No.
Well,
Demetrius. What else would you think? You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, hang on. You did ask her for naked pictures, right?
That's child porn.
Did you or did you not ask her for a naked picture?
I honestly don't remember.
Okay. Well, you did.
Okay.
You did. At the very beginning. I don't remember if you did again later on. I don't remember. But after you knew her age, you asked for a naked picture, right? So
right.
So just now she asked you if you look at CP and you looked at her in disgust. But yet you were asking for it. Because that would be CP, right? So you would have CP on your shit.
Definitely don't want that.
And to me, that's someone who has a major problem. Anyone who wants to look at that or asks for it or expects it, that's the most heinous thing in my opinion.
I promise you, I don't have a problem. I just
do
don't
you mind
make...
if I look through your gallery?
You can look through it.
Well, I don't want to... Is it open? I don't want I don't give a fuck about anything in there other than if you're talking to kids. Like, I don't give anything illegal in here. I don't care. We're not all saints.
No.
The only ones that I have are my girlfriend. That's it.
Cool. I mean, that's nothing illegal as long as she's not underage, you know?
She's 22. Okay. I don't have any problems with underage people and all that. I just don't always make the wisest decisions, and this was one of them.
I mean, this is a really bad decision, man.
It is.
So, like, I guess, how long were you going to stay out here with her?
Probably just until we got food.
But I thought you said you were going to go on a walk.
And then maybe... We talked about a walk in some park somewhere. I don't know what park.
And then were you just going to go home to your girlfriend and let her know how the vibe went? Or like...
Well, yeah. Like I said, I wasn't going to go back to her house. So I thought maybe come out here, eat, go on a walk, just kind of hang out, and then call it a day.
But then, like, afterwards, if you ended up, you did like her, what were you and your girlfriend going to do then? I mean, honestly. Because that had to be a thought in your mind, otherwise you wouldn't have come all the way out here. And you've been talking to this girl for a long time.
A couple of months, right?
Longer than that.
Last year.
Yeah. So, I mean, that's a long time to just say, I just have food, leave, and nothing else.
I guess I had thought about future hangouts, but I hadn't necessarily thought about exactly like step by step. Like, we're gonna do this, and then we're gonna do this, and then we're gonna do that. Just kind of, if we vibe, then next time I bring my girl back and we can all hang out, I guess. Or if we don't vibe, we can just not talk.
Well, what is you, your girlfriend, and this 13-year-old, what does it consist of hanging out is what I'm trying to say.
Just
honestly, like.
Movies, bowling, I talked about bowling in there. Just fun stuff that you can do. And then you go home and call it a day.
I mean, I would believe that, like 100% believe that if it weren't for those text messages.
Yeah, I know.
was the things that were said with the threesome and having sex and everything. That leads me to believe that if you guys were to meet up with this 13-year-old again, it would be more than just food and movies and hanging out. And I'm not saying it's right, but I would rather you just be honest. Because, you know, if you have a problem and you don't want this to ever happen again, and you want to move past this and you want to be better, you've got to admit that stuff. Because if you don't admit it to yourself, this could happen again. You realize that, right?
No, it couldn't.
I would hope to God not. But it's happening now.
Why couldn't it happen again?
Because now, in this sort of... which, honestly, this is a really bad position. This is where you kind of... you realize, like, hey, this was a really bad, decision to make. Like, the smart decision would have been to, like I said earlier, cut it off right at the beginning.
Right.
Instead of going any further.
Right.
Yeah, it would have been, but...
that's what I should have done differently.
Yeah, I mean... I feel like you're not being honest. Kind of giving me a headache.
No, I feel like you're just kind of circling around the actual
problem. It's honestly kind of giving me a headache.
Do you need Advil for that headache?
I do.
I left it in the car. Sorry.
We'll help
your
headache. I'm telling you, I don't have a problem with underage girls. That's what you asked me.
Right.
I do not. This is
just this one.
The very, very first time.
Okay. Well... so what do you think that, I mean, what do you think should happen? Do you think that you should just, do you deserve to go to jail? Or do you think that you should, like, what do you think?
Honestly, I would just like to forget all about it and just, I don't know.
Show me your hands. Stand up. Come on. I'm Deputy Cummins of Iowa County Sheriff's Office, okay? It's Deputy Taylor.
Sorry, bro.
Can I at least make a phone call? I don't have anything.
Videos.
There you go.
Okay.
You'll learn it.
What stuff do you have on him? What stuff do you have for him? All your checks and stuff, and that's something you can get to us?
Yeah. Pretty soon, man. I haven't had him go to the other one.
Okay, so
it should be soon. I'm not sure how much it is.
Oh, okay.
If you guys also need to know this, but he did mention that his girlfriend was aware of this.
Yeah, I was watching the live stream.
Yeah.
I don't know how true that is.
Yeah, we don't know either, but.
So they start talking like
May 23rd. He disappeared and came back. That's him getting a number.
We all need to get together again.
Right.
Maybe it'll be a little warmer this time.
Yeah.
When do you get sexual?
Yeah, so I'm trying to find out right now. Here he is asking for naked pictures for news.
Over here trying to kill us, getting us used to 60s and 70s, and then throwing us back into 20s. It's not fair.
It's brutal.
Yeah, to make hotels, we won't get blown away by a tornado. I didn't do a darn thing. Right? Thanks, guys.
Thank you.
Want to say anything?
Take that. Damn, it's cold.
Huh?
Yeah, I want to wait till they leave, yeah. Yeah, but there you go, guys. That's Demetrius, 24 years old. Got on a Greyhound from Indianapolis to come here to Terre Haute to meet a 13-year-old. I mean, he at least admitted that it was him talking and admitted that... I mean, he tried to lie at first, you know. Yeah, try to throw, like, don't... If you know this guy, don't assume that his girlfriend actually knew about the age. Because, yeah, because listen, if you do know this guy and, like, he does have a girlfriend... listen, he told me, the girl, the decoy, that his girlfriend was down to hang out and all that, but I tried to get him to let me talk to her, but he wouldn't do it, so I never talked to the girlfriend, so I'm thinking either one, he's not really with her anymore or something, he doesn't have a girlfriend, or two, she does not know the age, or doesn't even know that he's even talking to me. To this girl, so yeah, that or that. She exists at one point because she was in this phone. So there's pictures of her. Why don't I look through his phone? I hope not, because yeah. But yeah. So don't, if you know this guy, do not assume that his girlfriend knew. He would not let me, the decoy, talk to his girlfriend, which is a sign to me that she did not know. But he definitely knew, and he did say he wanted to fuck. He did say he wanted to teach her how to suck dick. He asked for naked pictures of her. He suggested having threesomes with his girlfriend. Who knows if that was the truth? Who knows how far he was lying about stuff and what he really didn't want to do? Who knows? You know, maybe he would have brought her to the girlfriend and told her to lie to the girlfriend and say you're a different age. Like, these guys do that too, so you never know. I don't believe his girlfriend's underage. If she's underage, then he's about to get a charge for CP. But I mean, I went through his phone, I didn't see anything. I didn't go through all of it, but obviously that doesn't really mean anything, but I didn't see anything. Yeah, it's decoy. Yeah, it's